Hey, what's up guys? Tyler here with Secureteam. Did you think that I pulled another Houdini on you? No. I simply took a couple weeks off for the Thanksgiving holiday, and I couldn't wait to get back, and here I am. So, let's continue this awesome journey. Now, before I want to get to the main topic of today's video, I want to show you guys a very intriguing piece of UFO footage that I had never seen before, and it was posted on UFO Reddit, showing a mildly short video titled, Couple Living in Germany Filmed This UFO back in 2009. So let's check it out.
Okay, jetzt geht's wieder. Jetzt passt wieder. Alter, was ist das? Ich hab sowas noch nie gesehen.
Boah, warum ist deine Kamera auf PN gestellt?
Ich hab das so eingestellt.
Was ist das für ein Riesen? Wow, Alter.
Scheiße, Mann. Was
ist
denn? Geht mitten unter die Bäume, dass ich... Ja, gut, so, jetzt passt's wieder. Jetzt seh ich's wieder. Alter, ich hab sowas noch nie gesehen. Hast du es gehört? Was war das?
Ja.
War das ein Hund?
Nein.
Voll komisch. Doch, das war so.
Hä?
Oh Scheiße, Mann.
Irgendwie habe ich jetzt Schiss.
Aber als Mann ist entfernt sich und zoomen kann ich nicht, nach wieder umschauen. Scheiße. Aber
wow.
Alter, wieso? Wow.
Okay, so there you have it. I'm totally amazed that I had never come across this before in the almost 2,000 videos I've done in the past decade, but you know what? There are hidden gems all over that people have never reported or thought to upload for fear of being called crazy or something like that, but nevertheless, we have it here. And what I love about this footage is that it looks like it's from 2009. The resolution, the quality of the video, the timestamp down in the corner, these are all relics of days we all, most of us, remember. And, well, we have what appears to be a, you know, your typical Bob Lazar-style flying saucer. You know, it looks like a saucer, it looks metallic. It has a great feature of what I like to call legit UFO videos. UFO videos that contain certain features that lead more to their validity than their fakeness. And that is when you have a UFO passing back behind something in the foreground, such as a tree, a building, or something of that nature. And so as we're watching this up close, and I'll go ahead and slow it down here, this thing is definitely passing behind these trees. If anyone can translate down below, I'd appreciate it. But whoever is recording it definitely seems to be very intrigued and spooked by the sighting of the object. The object is moving very fluid, very smooth through the sky, you know, giving off these sort of anti-gravity type vibes. And it also appears to me, at least, to be spinning. Due to changes and the light reflections on it. It just looks like at times it's spinning to me, but it's hard to tell with the resolution. But still, what is most amazing is this thing, you know, comes out from behind the trees, lingers there for a minute, and then blasts off into the distance, completely shocking the videographers. And it looks totally legit to me. I've seen a lot of CGIs, and especially when you're having things go behind trees and things of that nature, there has to be a lot of masking and editing done. And I just don't see that here. And even the way it blasts off at the end, it looks like something in real life that you would see blasting off, like a drone or a plane or something like that. So very amazing stuff. Some very interesting stuff posted on UFO Reddit as of late. So thanks to all of you guys posting there and who send in their footage to me. So tell me what you guys think down below of this footage purportedly captured above Germany in 2009. So we have a couple of topics to get to in this video, so don't click off just yet. You want to watch this entire thing. First of all, and the main topic of today's video is, well, there would seem to be a resurgence in that of mankind possibly playing with things that they shouldn't. Things in the way of creating robots. Robots that not only are terrifying to look at and they look like they're straight out of the movie Terminator, but also robots that can actually self-replicate, just like a natural living being here on Earth. But let's go ahead and start with the first, more terrifying, in my opinion, news story here of what people are calling, there's many terms, the most eerily terrifying and realistic robot that they have ever seen come out of the scientific slash tech community, with many relating it to the movie I, Robot. And so there's a video here I will play as I read the description from the article, where you'll see this robot, it seems almost like it's waking up and then looking at its hands and then kind of has this sort of terrifying look on its face. I think they were trying to make it look friendly, but it came off more like, I want to take your soul and then take over your planet. But I digress. The article states, quote, "This robot named Ameca, that's A-M-E-C-A, looks a little too real, and the internet is freaking out about it. While it's currently used for entertainment, its creators say Ameca, or Ameca, is a platform for future AI tech. Think Skynet, people. Think Terminator. Check out the world's most advanced human-shaped robot. Move, blink, gasp, and smile." And that's what you're watching. And so you're looking at Ameca's hyper-realistic facial expressions and gestures, the video garnering over 200,000 likes on Twitter. The company called Engineered Arts said, quote, "This is not CGI and is actually, you know, what the robot looks like in real life on camera." Although some people were not swayed. But still, it looks pretty real to me. I mean, we have some pretty advanced robots out there, and simple face expressions, you know, it's not that hard to do these days mechanically. The company who created it, Engineered Arts, described itself as, quote, "the UK's leading designer and manufacturer of humanoid entertainment robots." All right, perverts. "And has worked with clients such as Amazon Prime Video, TEDx, and National Geographic. The Ameca robot is known as AB, or Artificial Body. As Engineered Arts explains, human-like artificial intelligence needs a human-like artificial body. Hence, AI times AB, artificial intelligence with an artificial body." The company has a total of 4 different robot designs, and I'll let you guys check out the other videos of some of the other designs in the link down below from Business Insider. But yeah, apparently, I mean, this robot or these robots can display a huge range of human emotion, imitating human bone structure, skin texture, and expressions convincingly. And so as we go back finally to this still image here with our future overlords, you know, reaching its hand out to us, saying, come and accept your fate. You know, I don't think we should be playing around with robots and AI to an extent, you know what I mean? So, Terminator, just remember that. Now, next in news, talking about robotics, something even more amazing, which is that scientists have just unveiled the world's first living robots, and now they can reproduce. By clustering these free-floating stem cells together, what they're calling xenobots can assemble baby bots. Early last year, a team of researchers announced the world's first living machines, bundles of stem cells from African clawed frogs that could be programmed to accomplish certain tasks. The sand grain-sized cells could successfully move microscopic objects, whiz around petri dishes, and even self-heal. And so to put the article in a nutshell, they took some cells from some frogs, mixed it in with some, you know, like nanotechnology robots, to the point where we now have these totally robotic entities that are, again, only the size of a grain of sand, but that can move around, as you're seeing in the video from the article, and also then replicate, reproducing, or making a copy of itself. And this is amazing news. I mean, this is groundbreaking. These xenobots are able to work together, pushing around single cells to form new xenobots. It's a process called kinetic self-replication, a process only observed in molecules and not living things. One xenobot parent can begin a pile, and then by chance, a second parent can push more cells into that pile, and so on, generating a so-called child. This is how they self-replicate. But bottom line, guys, we have microscopic robots that now have the ability to be programmed and to self-replicate by themselves, just like any other microorganism on Earth that continues copying cells and molecules to the point where it then forms a creature or a living being. So, you know, toss in some of these xenobots into Mr. Terrifying Terminator here, and let's see what we get, you know? Let's have some fun. Let's see what 2022 brings us. So tell me what you think down below. I think at times we're playing with fire, but the way the world is right now, I'm all for having the edge on technology and robotics and, you know, things like that. So before we end this video with a couple of images taken from planet Mercury of some very alien, artificial looking objects found down on the surface, I want to give you guys a sneak peek of the new film poster that I was honored to play a part in. I had a cameo in the film and worked with the director of the film. It's called Secret Space UFOs Rise of the TR-3B. Created and directed by Darcy Weir, this film continues from its predecessor, simply called Secret Space UFOs, wherein this film, Rise of the TR-3B, delves into a single topic, the mysterious TR-3B, or the mysterious silent black triangles that have been seen in our skies for years now, thought to be possibly built by our government and that incorporate some sort of alien technology that allowed them to create a silent black triangular craft that uses anti-gravity as its propulsion, meaning that this thing can stop and hover in the air. It can fly at Mach 20,000, you know, and make a sudden right-hand turn, stop on a dime, totally defy physics. And I've reported on these sightings for years now. And like I said, I was happy to be a part of the film. And well, here is the poster for that film. The trailer, which I will exclusively break on the channel, will be coming next this week. So look out for that. I'm really excited because this film doesn't just show you some really cool footage that I've never even seen before of these silent triangles, but it goes into the history behind the myth, where it all started, giving us a glimpse from beginning to the middle to the end of what these mysterious black triangles hovering in our skies could be. The film featuring a number of experts from the UFO field to avionics and more. And I'm really excited for Darcy and this film, which I got to be in. You know, I got to be a part of it. It was cool. And be on camera, which I hate to be on camera, but, you know, the film, the director insisted. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoy it when it comes out. Again, the trailer will be coming soon. So with that, lastly today, I want to show you a couple of pictures that were snapped from the planet Mercury. Now, we never really hear a lot about Mercury, and it makes you wonder why. Is it because they want us to think that it's just another cold, lifeless rock floating out there in space? Or is it because there's something there, or there are things there that they don't want us to know about? So the first image I want to show you guys, which I have gone ahead and zoomed in, it's just, you know, it's in a massive crater field down on the surface. But when zooming in on a particular crater, I want you guys to notice almost right dead center, there looks to be a very tall standing building, almost like a door, because you can see what looks to be a dark entrance into it. Now, the sun is shining down from right to left. So picture the sun up in the upper right corner, casting down. That's why the right side of the crater, the inside of it, is in shadow, and the left side is being hit by the sun, and why all of the shadows of any objects in the picture are being cast down to the left behind them. And so we have this mound here coming up from the ground. You can see the obvious sort of triangular shadow being cast back to the left down on the bottom of the crater. And then we have this, what looks almost like a perfect, you know, curved cave entrance or, you know, tunnel entrance that very well may lead to something underground. Very, very interesting image. Tell me what you guys think. Again, the object is definitely standing tall. It's casting a shadow behind it, has a big, large, dark opening. It makes you wonder. So in this last image, and I can't seem to find the exact NASA image of this, but I found a copy of it next to planet Mercury here, but it's good enough for us to zoom in. So we're seeing the planet again, littered with craters, and we have two more strange artificial looking objects seen in two different craters. So as we zoom in here, the first crater off to the right, there seems to be what looks like a tower of some sort coming up from the dark shadows of the crater that the sun is not being able to hit. And we see what looks like this sort of tall cylindrical, you know, exhaust pipe or something like that sticking out up into the sunlight where the sun can actually hit it. And if you'll also notice down here right at the crater's edge, the crater stops from being a perfectly circled, you know, formed crater, a perfect circle. There looks to almost be what looks like engineering going on, like almost crane type equipment, where we have, you know, what look like multiple poles or pieces that are crisscrossing and attached together, along with one long piece that then connects it, almost like a, you know, a radio tower. Or a crane, or something like that. It, you know, it looks like a construction site. But again, I thought it was definitely noteworthy. Tell me what you think. And then as we move over to the crater, just, you know, right next to it, right at the crater's edge, in the shadow, or, well, again, looks to be popping up out of the shadows, we have what look like two little domes, which could be the tops of two towers. We then have also lit up this little U-shaped thing, that's all I could describe it as, that looks to connect to the two domes or two tower tops. And you can actually see, if you look close enough, because the sun is coming from the left, shining down towards the right, if you look, you can actually see what looks like a black cylindrical shadow that perfectly lines up with these two dots here that are popping up out of the crater. As if you are looking down on two towers, and these two towers have, you know, these round domes on the top of them, and that's what we're seeing sticking up, complete with shadow being cast down on the crater bottom. So again, two very strange craters, one that looks to have some engineering going on, craned or antenna-like structures, and then we have these two towers or domes that look to be connected together by this U-shaped object along with a shadow being cast. So two very interesting images from planet Mercury. Tell me what you all think. Like all of these other planets or moons, we have never failed to find remnants of construction or buildings or just artificial structures that don't come naturally. So again, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Much more to come. I'm back from break. I'm excited to get back to it. So subscribe, stay tuned, be sure to like, throw me a comment. The algorithm really loves that when you like and you comment, because it shows that you enjoyed this video and you want to see more like it. So I hope you all had a wonderful Thanksgiving. If you didn't, go eat some turkey anyway. It's delicious. Go watch the movie Terminator, and I will see you all back in just a bit. Stay safe, guys.